saved you, and he's kept you. He's covered you all of these years for this specific time. Not because, you know, he's given you front row seats so that, you know, you can enjoy the show. But he's kept you. Your mind and the questions in your hearts, all of the things that you've ever wondered, and, you know, the things that have challenged your faith. God has answered them, but now God is saying, I have kept you, I have preserved you, because now I want you to step on it. I want you to go for it. I don't want you to hold back anymore. I know that in early days there was a stirring, and there was this fire on you. In early days, that I'm not going to hold nothing back from God. As time has gone by, I'm not saying that you just kind of put it in cruise control or neutral and you just kind of parked it. But God is saying, now is the time. Remember that first time. Remember and come back. I've saved you, and I have protected you. There, God is saying that there's so many things that could have pulled you out of his kingdom, pulled you out of his will. There's so many things that could have warped your minds and twisted you, but God said, I have preserved you. And now I want you to let my glory shine through your lives. I want you to be a reflection of me. I don't want you to wait anymore. And, you know, sometimes, like, we get so caught up with life and all these other things, and, you know, we think, well, we've been preaching the rapture since we first got saved. I remember being a kid and watching rapture movies at 5 years old, you know, having nightmares. But, you know, and so I remember hearing this my whole life, and you guys have heard this all through your salvation. But the truth is that God has saved you because of this very moment. He's saying, you know what, that time is coming, that time is now. But now is the time as well to lift up your eyes and to look. When he says, lift up your eyes and look out into the harvest, because we're so caught up right here. There's a world. There's needs right before you. And I have saved you. I have preserved you because I have a plan for you right now. And yes. Now God says, step on it. Go for it. Yes. You know, don't hold anything back anymore. Even those little things that you think, well, they're not a big deal. God says they are a big deal. I don't want no hindrance. I don't want no drag in your life. I want everything. Jesus says, take my yoke upon you and learn from me. Because my yoke is easy and my burden is light. What he's saying is, anyway, if your desire is for the kingdom of God and those things, then there's nothing else. But that it's not a weight. It might seem like a burden, but Jesus says it's not. It's a burden for the lost, and I'll take care of everything else. Cast off your worries, cast off your cares, and I'll take care of everything. Okay, God is using you right now, and he's going to use you. He's going to use everything that you have, all your understanding. All the knowledge that God has given into your minds, and, you know, the discernment, God is going to bring it now. It's like, you know, you save up. You save up, and one day you realize that's why you were saved. God has done that with you. He's added and added and added and added. And we say, now it's time to use it. Now it's time to put it out there. Now it's time to be real and make you stand. All right? I'm going to pray for you. Believe God to help you. Father, touch this couple right now. In Jesus' name, by your spirit and your power, Lord.